that don't kill me, can only make me stronger.
Greg, it's great speaking with you. Look, man, you're a longtime friend of mine. I consider you family. Before we start talking about exercise and stuff, I just want to know, how are you doing? How's your family doing throughout this tough time?
Thanks, Rudy. Same back to you. We are doing good. It's a very strange scenario we are all living under right now. It's kind of surreal, isn't it? Yes, family is fine. We're all home. We're all together. And things are good on that front. How are you? How are you managing? How's everybody in your world doing?
Everybody's good. We're taking it one day at a time. But, you know, one of the things for myself and, of course, my brother and my sister, we like going to the gym. And, of course, the gyms are all closed. And you're kind of going a little stir crazy, going, well, I want to work out, I want to do something, but I'm not sure what to do. You, my friend, are an expert at this. What can folks do during this time? Because, you know, people aren't sure, should I go out jogging? Are there things I can do at home? What can we do to stay fit during this time?
Well, you know, it's a quick question, Rudy. And, you know, if anything, there are going to be all kinds of little things that are going to come out of this that are going to improve everybody's lives. And I think the realization of exactly what you can do without the big fancy gym membership is going to be one of those things. I mean, we can easily get plenty of exercise and really take care of ourselves, even at home, even without any type of equipment at all. And just body weight exercises are just almost as effective. And you know what? Just as effective for 99% of the population who has no desire to become, you know, ripped and magazine cover model, body weight exercises are more than enough to keep you active, keep you healthy, and to keep you moving well into your old age.
Is this the standard push-ups, sit-ups, like those kind of things?
So you can't go wrong with those things. They are. It is the standard. You know, you can't go wrong with, I've been telling people, just do a series of, like, if you want to run through a series of 10 jumping jacks, 10 push-ups, and 10 bodyweight squats, run through that with as little rest as possible, and then do that three to five times. That's going to take you about 20 minutes, and that's a real solid workout, and it's going to hit every bit of it's going to hit all of your muscles, and it's going to give you a little bit of the cardio and the jumping jacks as well. So, I mean, that is really basic. It's really simple, and you can literally stand up from your couch or chair and do it where you stand.
What about if you want to do curls or things like that? I remember back in the day, I think I've seen people doing this. They would take maybe two cans out of their in the kitchen and start using those for curls and stuff. Can you do stuff like that?
Absolutely. One of the things that I would work really well is we all now have these reusable grocery store bags, these canvas bags that are nice and strong and sturdy. Fill those up with canned goods, make it as heavy as you can, and then right there you have a sort of a homemade dumbbell. You can do all kinds of stuff with it. You can do curls with it. You can do some presses with it. You can do some overhead presses with it. So you can get really creative with this household stuff. But if you have something that is easy to hold, that you're not going to drop easily, and it has a little bit of weight to it, grab it and start moving it. Push it, pull it, lift it. Whatever you can do with it, get at it and keep yourself active. And don't let yourselves become a victim of the couch. I know it's so easy. Let's just binge watch all day long and stay seated down on the couch. And that's really not the best thing that you can do for yourself. You know, the neighborhoods are pretty quiet. I've taken the dog for numerous walks. Every time I walk into the room, the dog looks at me and says, no, I'm not going for another walk. But, you know, it's one of those things where I know we're practicing social distance. So, you know, if you see somebody coming, you can make sure you're staying 6 feet clear of anybody. But getting out for a walk, the weather's starting to warm up a little bit. You know, the most important thing we can do is just keep moving.
Something you said that I want to emphasize very much, too, because I've seen a lot of people have been doing this. You mentioned about that, the binge eating. That's something that could really hurt us, can it?
You know, it really can. And, you know, because we're used to going about our daily lives. And I know You're certainly no different than everybody else about the busy, hectic schedules that we normally lead. So every now and then, if we indulge a little bit on the odd occasion, usually our busy, active lifestyles, that's not going to have much of an effect. But that busy, active lifestyle seems to have been halted temporarily. And so now we're not moving near as much as we have been. So now those little binges that we allow ourselves, they're going to start to add up. So I'm not saying don't go on a little binge every now and then, but please be cognizant of the fact that, you know, it's going to have a little bit more of an effect because you're not getting up and you're not moving as much as you normally would. So make sure you are getting that movement in, making sure you're doing some jumping jacks at the very least, going for a walk, getting down, doing some push-ups and working up a sweat, get that heart rate elevated. And that's going to make the little binge eating while you're binge watching have that much less of an impact.
Thank you so much for this. Look, people are going to probably want some personal advice. Is there any way they can get in touch with you through social media? And also, once everything goes back to normal, if they're looking for a trainer, how can they contact you also?
Well, our website is Greg MacDonald Fitness. That's MacDonald, GregMacDonaldFitness.ca. And info at GregMacDonaldFitness.ca as well is my contact info, and also Greg MacDonald Fitness on Instagram. And also the gym I work at, it's called PSP, Prototype Sports Performance. They can look that up and contact either myself or the other trainer I work with, Justin Vince. We would love to help out anybody during this period. You know, we are offering free advice for anybody who's stuck at home and is looking for a good workout or something to keep them moving. And, and if you're looking for a place to hit the weights and really get moving once this is all over with, then, yeah, please don't hesitate to contact us.
Greg, thank you so much. Look, all the best to you and your family. We'll definitely talk to you, my friend.
Thanks a lot. Really appreciate it. Always love talking to you. Take care of yourself. Take care of your family. And you guys be well, okay?